called to share in the ministry of Christ and of the whole church, to preach and teach the Word of God, and to faithfully administer the sacraments of holy baptism and holy communion, to lead the people of God in worship and prayer, to lead persons to faith in Jesus Christ, to exercise pastoral supervision, to order the life of the congregation, counsel the troubled, and declare the forgiveness of sin, to lead the people of God in obedience to Christ's mission in the world, to seek justice and peace and freedom for all people, and to take a responsible place in the government of the church and in service in and to the community. These are the duties of an elder. Do you believe that God has called you to the life and work of an elder?
I do so believe.
Will you, for the sake of the church's life and mission, covenant to participate in the order of elders? Will you give yourself to God through the order of elders in order to sustain and build each other up in prayer, study, worship, and service?
I will, with the help of God, and the help of my sisters and brothers, in the order of elders.
As these persons are recognized or ordained by God and the church for the ministry of elders to which we believe they have been called by the Holy Spirit, let us now pray for them. We praise you, eternal God, because you have called us to be a priestly people, offering to you acceptable worship through Jesus Christ our Lord, apostle and high priest, shepherd and bishop of our souls. We thank you that by dying Christ has overcome death, and having ascended into heaven, has poured forth gifts abundantly on your people, making some apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers to equip the saints for the work of ministry, to build up Christ's body, and to fulfill your gracious purpose in the world. Give to these your servants the grace and power they need to serve you in ministry. Make them faithful pastors, patient teachers, and wise counselors. Enable them to serve without reproach, to proclaim the gospel of salvation, to administer the sacraments of the new covenant, and to offer with all your people spiritual sacrifices acceptable to you. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Almighty God, pour upon Lord and Godwin the Holy Spirit for the office and work of an elder in Christ's holy church. Amen.
Amen.
Lord, take authority as an elder to preach the word of God, to administer the sacraments, and to order the life of the church, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Spirit for the office and work of an elder in Christ's holy church. Amen.
Amen.
Tim, take authority as an elder to preach the word of God, to administer the holy sacraments, and to order the life of the church. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Almighty God, pour upon Diane Michelle Keniston the Holy Spirit for the office and work of an elder in Christ's holy church. Amen. Diane, take authority as an elder to preach the word of God, to administer the holy sacraments, and to order the life of the church. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Ha 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 ha!
Almighty God, pour upon Kelly Louise Martin the Holy Spirit for the office and work of an elder in Christ's holy church.
Amen.
Kelly, take authority as an elder to preach the word of God, to administer the holy sacraments, and to order the life of the church. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.